Hello students, today we will explain the next crop pest, blister beetle, commonly called as flower beetle. This pest belongs to phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Coleoptera, family Meloidae, genus Melabris, and the species Pustulata. So this is also a type of beetle attacking on to the variety of flowering plants. Blister beetle is an important pest of bajra, which occasionally breaks out or increasing its number in a epidemic form in some localities. The host plants of the blister beetle or a flower beetle are bajra, jawar, beans, and cucurbits are the main host plants, and alternative host plants are cotton and many flowers and the ornamental plants like hibiscus. The pest is widespread and common but not commercially serious. Then we'll explain regarding its identification marks. The beetles are stoutly built, black with yellow or red strips or transverse bands across their wings, and measures about 2.5 cm length and 12 mm width. The other species are smaller with a light brown or greenish blue color. As compared to other beetles, they are soft bodied with thinner wings. These beetles secretes acidic substance, and if crushed on a human body forms blisters, and therefore their name is blister beetle. So with respect to the identification marks of the blister beetle, they are stout, well built, black colored with a yellow or red bands, and its wings shows transverse bands, alternate transverse bands, which are either yellowish in color or red in color. But overall the beetle appears to be black in color with a yellow or red colored transverse bands, and having length up to 2.5 cm and width of 12 mm. And other species of the blister beetle, they are smaller in size with a light brown or straw color or greenish blue color. And as compared to other beetles, these beetles, blister beetles, are soft bodied and with a thinner wings. And most important, that is, these beetles secretes a saliva which is having strong acids and which forms the blisters on the surface of the skin. Even if the blister beetles are crushed on the human body, will also cause the blisters, and therefore the name of the blister beetles are called as a blister beetles. So this is the figure showing the adult blister beetle. So the beetles, these are again the insects having elongated body with head, thorax, and abdomen, three pairs of legs and the two pairs of wings. So wings are hold or oppressed on the body, representing the elytra along the surface. Then having head provided with a club shaped antennae, then thorax with three segments, and abdomen which remaining behind the wings. So adults are well built or stout and having black colored wings and possessing transverse or alternate black and yellow or red colored bands on the entire surface of the elytra or the four pair of wings. So this is the figure representing the adult blister beetle. Then we'll explain the life cycle of the blister beetle. The female beetles laying the eggs in the soil, which are fertilized eggs and which are deposited in the form of batches. Eggs are white in color and which hatch or develops into a larvae within a period of 15 days. And these larvae, after hatching or its emergence from the egg, feeding onto the eggs of the Orthoptera like a grasshopper. So the female lays eggs, mated female or fertilized female lays eggs in the soil in the batches, which are white in color and which develop into a larva within a period of 15 days or fortnight. And these larvae, after hatching, feeding onto the egg pods of the Orthoptera or a grasshopper like insects, and are thus considered as a beneficial insects or the beetles. They pass through different stages dissimilar in appearance. So larval stage develops or getting transformed into several dissimilar stages. The larval stages are often sluggish with a large body and reduced legs. The pupation takes place in a soil. The pupation also taking place in a soil. Eggs develops into soil, hatching into a larvae, which are feeding onto the eggs of the Orthopteran insects like grasshopper. Then larva pass through three instars or three different stages, and then undergoes the pupation, which is a dormant or sluggish phase of the life cycle that occur in also soil. So the lateral larval stages, which are often sluggish and with a large body and reduced legs. The pupation taking place in a soil. The beetle emerge from the pupae are large and having length up to 25 to 35 millimeters. The body length of the blister beetle is up to 2.5 centimeter, but the length of the pupa is up to 3.5 centimeter in a length, with a bright conspicuous red or yellow and black band pattern of the coloration. So there are alternate black and red or black and yellow bands onto the body of the pupa. So the pupa is also having same pattern of the bands, that is black and red or black and yellow on the body or the on the pupal body, or this is the black and red color or black and yellow colored band pattern or the coloration found among the pupa also. They are rather sluggish in behavior, but are strong flyers. So these insects, that is blister beetles, they are having good ability or capacity of the flight or flying. The beetles remain active from August to December. So these beetles are usually found active or in the crop, feeding onto the variety of kharif crops like bajra, jawar, etc. But even the cocker beets, but the beetle are active during the period of August to December. Then nature of damage. Beetles attack usually the inflorescence and feed onto the pollens and petals of the flowers. So the main attack or infestation of the blister beetle on the crop is the flowers and feeding onto the inflorescence, that is the different parts of the flowers like pollen grains or the petals, and adversely affecting the grain setting, means it hinders or inhibits the process of fertilization. So, and adversely affecting the grain setting. In case of severe infestation, ear heads without grains are seen in the field, and this is due to the inhibition of the process of fertilization. So, mainly the blister beetle feeding onto the flowers or the different parts of the flowers, and ultimately affecting the seed setting, or after which the fruit setting or the flower setting, as per the plant which is producing the particular product. It may be a flowering plant, it may be plants providing the grains or the fruits. So, ultimately the quantity of the particular crop will be reduced due to the attack of the blister beetles onto the variety of flowering plants or the crops during usually the kharif season. Then control measures. Collection of the beetles by hand insect nets, or they may be attracted by light traps and then can be killed in a kerosene water. Even dusting of 10% BHC at the rate of 25 kg per hectare is effective in controlling the pest. The population of the adult blister beetles can be effectively suppressed or reduced or killed by spraying the emulsion of any one of the following insecticides. And these insecticides are chlorpyrifos, commonly called as Darshan, 20 effective concentration at the rate of 0.025%, that is 1.25 ml of chlorpyrifos per liter of water, or Quinalfos or Ecolux, 25 effective concentration at the rate of 0.05%, with a quantity of 2 ml per liter of water, and Fosolon or Zolon, 35 effective concentration at the concentration that is 0.05%, and quantity can be taken 1.5 ml per liter of water. So, these are the three different type of insecticides, or their emulsions with a variable concentration can be spread in the crop so as to kill or the control the blister beetles from the respective crop field. So, this is about the blister beetle. So, these are important insect pests which are attacking onto the different parts of the flowers and affecting the seed setting or fruit setting of the particular crop. Then next type of pest, rice weevil. So, till now we have explained about five different crop pests such as jawar stem borer, red cotton bug, mango stem borer, blister beetle, and one more, that is brinjal fruit borer. So, already we have explained about the five different crop pests such as one, that is jawar stem borer, then red cotton bug, then brinjal fruit borer, then fourth one is a mango stem borer, and fifth one, that is a blister beetle. So, these are the five different type of crop pest which are enlisted in our syllabus, and two type of stored grain pest, that is rice weevil and pulse beetle. So, now we will explain the first type of stored grain pest, important stored grain pest, that is rice weevil. So, rice weevil is also belonging to a phylum Insecta, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Coleoptera, family Curculionidae, genus Cytophyllus and the species Oryge. So these are the small weevils or the beetles. These are the beetle category of insects as they belongs to the order Coleoptera. So this is very serious pest of the stored grains as well as grains in the farm storage. It is cosmopolitan in distribution. Identification marks of rice weevil. The adults are small weevils, measures up to 4 mm in length, with a reddish brown or a dark brown or almost black in color, with a cylindrical body and a long curved rostrum or the mouth parts. The head is prolonged, the head is much elongated in front into a slender snout with a chewing type of mouth parts located at the tip of the head. The functional wings remain hidden beneath the dark brown elytra with the four light reddish or yellowish spots, and the insect is able to fly. So these small weevils, they can fly, are capable of flying also. The lifespan of the adult weevil or the rice weevil is 4 to 5 months. The grubs or the larvae are whitish in color, having very small, that is 0.5 mm in length, and legless or apodous. These are the legless larvae or apodous with a yellow brown head. They are always found inside the kernel. Larvae always remains inside the food grains or the kernels of the food grains. The host plants of the Cytophyllus oryge, host that is different crops such as rice, wheat, maize and other grains. So these are the host crops or the food grains which are usually consumed by the Cytophyllus oryge or the rice weevil. Cytophyllus oryge mainly prefers to the rice, whole grains of the rice, but they can also feed on to the wheat, maize and other grains. So this is the figure showing life cycle of the rice weevil. In first figure we can see there is a food grain of the wheat representing a spherical hole or the mark representing the egg, which is laid in a small C-shaped groove. So while laying the eggs, the female weevils or the rice weevils, they prepare a shallow hole on the surface of the food grain, and in which it deposits a egg. And after deposition of the fertilized egg, the female releases some sort of mucilaginous substance or the secretion, with the help of which the egg remain attached with the surface of the egg. So after the embryonic development, the larva which is emerging out or hatching out from the egg, that penetrates or that feeds onto the surface of the grain and prepares a small hole and enters inside and feeding onto the starchy material. So within a period of 6 to 7 days, the larva hatch out and will then penetrate into the food grain and feeding onto the internal floor material or the starchy material of the food grains, like even rice or wheat, etc. So after hatching, it feeds on to the starchy material or the floor material of the food grains, and it always remains the larva or the grub always remains inside of the food grain. So in a next figure we can see the larva, which is a small C-shaped larva, measures up to 5 millimeter in a length and having a white color. Then next figure shows larva inside the grain, and on other side there is a pupa. So the larval lifespan is about 25 to 35 days. So within that period, the larva undergoes several moultings and getting transformed into one stage to other stage, and while its development it continuously feed onto the food material and results into complete hollowing of the food grain, and after which it undergoes a pupation, or then pupation lasts for again 7 to 8 days, and then emerge out the adult beetle of the rice weevil. So in first figure we can see the life stages of the Cytophyllus oryzae. In the second figure also we can see the eggs, which are somewhat cylindrical in a shape, and on other side there is a adult beetle of the Cytophyllus oryzae having head, thorax, abdomen, and head is provided with elongated beak or rostrum together with a pair of antennae, and that is possessing the chewing type of mouth parts also. Then head and below, behind which there is a thorax having three segments and possessing two pairs of wings, but which are again elongated, either brown in color or reddish in color, dark brown or reddish brown, or even having a black color of the elytra or the body of the adult beetles. So this is about the figures representing the life cycle of the Cytophyllus oryzae. Then we'll explain the life cycle of the rice weevil in details. So the female of the rice weevil starts laying eggs when it is of 5 days old, and or even immediately after its emergence from the pupa, within a period of 5 days it starts its breeding activities, that is laying eggs. The female bores a small round hole in the soft part of the grain by means of its mouth parts, and there she lays a single egg and sealing it with a mucilaginous secretion. The eggs are translucent, white, oval or minute, with a size of 0.7 by 0.3 millimeter in a size. A female lays about 300 to 400 number of eggs during her lifetime. So total number of eggs laid by the a female is 300 to 400, but it lays single egg onto the food grain. The incubation period varies from 4 to 7 days in a summer and 6 to 9 days in a winter. So this is the difference of duration of the embryonic development for the transformation of the egg into a larvae. So during summer days, the duration of the incubation period is only 4 to 7 days, but in a winter month it extends up to 9 days. The grub or larva hatches out of the egg and is eggless, or a apodous larva having translucent white with a fleshy body and yellowish brown head. The young tiny grub bores into the grain kernel or coat and lives within the grain, feeding on its starchy or a floor material or the contents, and hollows it completely and leaving only the outer shell or the coat or kernel intact. There are 4 larval instars, and the larval period lasts for 25 to 35 days. Means during the larval development there are 3 moultings, and it passes through 4 larval instars. The development of the larva or the grub, there are 3 moultings and passes through 4 instars, and larval period lasts for 25 to 35 days. So within the during this period of 25 to 35 days, larva feed completely inside onto the starchy material or the floor material, and resulting into complete hollowing of the food grains. The full grain, the full grown grub or a larva makes a pupal cell inside the grain. So pupation of the life cycle or the third stage or the phase of life cycle, that is pupation, also taking place inside the food grains. So while pupation, the mature larva or fourth instar larva secretes a cell or a cocoon around its body and undergoes the dormant phase of life cycle, that is pupation, inside the food grain. The pupa is curved or humpy, representing the structure like electric bulb in appearance. Humpy, curved or humpy in appearance, and takes 3 to 6 days to emerge into the adult. So for this, for the transformation of the larva to adult, takes 3 to 6 days for the complete transformation of the larva into the adult insect or the beetle. The weevils, on its emergence or after its emergence, the immediately it starts its breeding activities, because the within a period of 5 days, the adult beetles or the weevils, they undergoes their breeding activity. So immediately after its emergence from the pupa, immediately after its release or emergence from the pupa, weevil immediately starts its breeding activity and gives rise to new generation for destruction of the grain. So the life cycle of the rice weevils remain continue one after another, and this will destroy large quantity of the stored food grains in the storage houses. Several generations are possible during the normal storage season of the grains. There are several generations taking place during the period of storage of the grains in the houses or godowns. The adults live on an average for 2 to 5 months. The adults live or survive, can survive for 2 to 5 months. So this is much longer period of its survival, and during which it can feed onto the large quantity of food grains, can destroy the large quantity of the food grains in the storage. Means the rice weevils or this type of stored grain paste, both stages, that is larvae, grub and the adults, both are destructive or harmful on to the stored grains in the houses. So means, and that's why it can destroy large quantity of the food grains and making it unfit for the human consumption or the seed purpose. Then regarding nature of damage, generally infestation starts in the grains only during the storage. The Cytophilus oryzae or the rice weevils feeds on whole grains of the rice, wheat, jowar, bajra, maize, barley, etc. Both adults and larvae feed voraciously on the grains, and so that grain become completely spoiled and become unfit for human consumption and seed purpose. A thin tunnel or a hole is formed by the grub from the surface towards inside of the grain, and a circular exit hole and a stained spot, may be white or yellow, on the surface of the grain kernel is the symptom of damage. In case of heavy infestation, the grains become a mass of broken vegetable matter, means there is a complete breaking of the food grains and resulting into the total spoiling of the food grains due to the hollowing, then presence of silken cocoons or feces. So the food grains, intact food grains, or the stored intact food grains can be transformed into a vegetable matter or a broken matter called as a vegetable matter. The adults eat small amount of grain. The adult eat small amount of grain, making shallow holes with a rugged or zigzag edges, but the amount of damage thus caused is a negligible as compared to the complete hollowing of the grain by the larval stages, which results into hollowed grains and leading to reduction in a weight and its food value. Means the damage caused by the larvae is much more than the damage caused due to the adult weevils. Then control measures. To control the stored grain pest like rice weevil, both control methods or measures are adopted, that is preventive and curative. So first we'll explain about the preventive control measures. First we'll explain about preventive control measures. This control measure is employed to protect fresh stock from the attack of the stored grain pest. Preventive measures are usually adopted or employed for the protection of the fresh stock of the food storages from the attack of the pest. So there are various measures which we can explain one by one. So first one, that is after harvesting, immediately after harvesting, dry the food grains in a sunlight completely or sufficiently so that the moisture content of the food grains should be reduced to less than 8%, because most of the stored grain pest cannot multiply in a grains at this percentage of the moisture, or due to the complete drying, the surface of the kernel or the coat of the food grain become very hard and the mouth parts of the weevils or the stored grain pest cannot be operated onto the tough surface of the food grain. So this is what the reason, this is the reason for protection or prevention of the severe attack of the stored grain pest onto the food grains. This is because due to the complete drying, the food grain become so hard, or the tough or kernel or the coat become tough or the hard, and the mouth parts of the stored grain pest cannot be operated onto the food grains, and ultimately the food grains get protected due to the complete drying of the food grains, which will reduce the moisture contents of the food grains up to less than 8%, and ultimately protecting the food grains. So complete drying or the sun drying of the food grains after harvesting is best remedy or the preventive measure for the protection of the food grains to avoid the attack of the stored grain pest. Then after drying the food grains completely in a sunlight, store the grains in a new gunny bags, so that the grains will be free from infestation or the presence of larvae, eggs, or the adult beetles or the weevils or the life stages in the old gunny bags. So after complete drying, the food grains should be stored in a new gunny bags which are free from life stages of the pest. Then thirdly, we can use neem leaves, mercury, mixing of ash powder of the sweet flag rhizome, that is Acorus calamus, etc., in grains, or smearing or applying the grains with plant oils are the indigenous practices used by the rural peoples for protection of the stored grains from the attack of different pests. So use of neem leaves, mercury, mixing of ash powder of the sweet flag rhizome, or smearing of the plant oils. These are the indigenous practices, and that could also help for the protection of the food grains from the attack of different pests. If the old gunny bags are to be used for the storage of the food grains, they should be fumigated. They should be fumigated or disinfected or sterilized by the fumigation of ethylene dibromide at the rate of 3 kg per 100 cubic meter area for 5 to 7 days, which helps to check or to control the cross infestation. So, if we are using the old gunny bags for the storage purpose, then we will have to fumigate them, we will have to disinfect them by using the ethylene dibromide at the rate of 3 kg per 100 cubic meter area of the fumigation in a airtight condition for 5 to 7 days, and which will help to check or to kill all the stages of life cycle of the stored grain paste. It is also achieved by applying 5% BHC or 0.06% pyrethrum dust at the rate of 25 gram per square meter, or sprays of BHC, pyrethrum or malathion can also be useful for the complete destruction of the stages of this paste. The bags should then be stored in an insect-free godown. So, after either fumigation or the spraying of the suitable fumigant or insecticide, we can store these bags, disinfected bags or fumigated or sterilized bags in a insect-free godown for the prevention of the entry of the weevils or the stored grain paste in the freshly fumigated or sprayed gunny bags to avoid the infestation. Then, to make the godown insect free, one or more of the following methods can be used. That is, all dirt, refuse material should be removed and destroyed, and all the cracks, crevices, holes in walls, floors or ceiling of the godown should be filled in with the cement material or cement concrete. So, complete cleaning of the storehouse or the godown or the warehouse, whatever will we use for the storage purpose. So, all dirt, refuse material from the storehouse should be removed or properly cleaned and destroyed, and all the cracks, crevices or the holes in the walls or floors or ceiling of the godowns should be filled up with a cement material. Even the rat holes should be closed or filled up by using the cement concrete material or sand mixed with glass pieces. So, the rat holes or the burrows can be filled and closed with a use of the cement concrete material, or we can use the sand mixed with a glass pieces into the rat burrows, and after which it can be closed by using the cement material. Then, fumigation of the godown with ethylene dibromide. Fumigation of the godown by preparing airtight condition, we can fumigate the storehouse or the godown by using ethylene dibromide. Even we can use the spray of the insecticides such as pyrethrum, malathion or BHC to avoid the chance of contamination or the infestation or the occurrence of the paste. So, this is about the preventive measures. Now, we will explain the curative measures. So, whenever there is a infestation or the attack of the stored grain paste in the food grains or stored food grains, when there is a infestation noticed, when there is a severe infestation or the weevils which are attacking the stored grain paste, then we will have to employ the curative measures. So, the curative measures are essential when the grains, food grains, stored food grains get infested with a stored grain paste. And these are, first, sieving. Sieving of the food grains by using the sieves. So, sieving and cleaning removes all the stages of the paste. Secondly, after above method, or that is sieving and cleaning, the grains, food grains, must be dried or followed by sunning, that is in a sunlight. So after cleaning and sieving and cleaning of the food grains should be dried under sun, and the fumigation with a suitable, followed by suitable fumigation, followed by fumigation by using suitable fumigants. So when the infestation is noticed, or when there is a severe infestation of the stored grain paste in the storehouse, the entire quantity of the food grains should be sieved and cleaned to remove all the stages of paste, after which the food grains must be dried under sun, and after which, after complete drying or sunning, the food grains should be stored in the godown where the fumigation practice can be done by using suitable fumigant like ethylene dibromide or methyl chloride. The larvae and adults are killed by exposing them for 48 hours of the vapors of the ethylene dichloride or carbon tetrachloride mixture under gas proof covers. So after drying of the food grains, infested food grains, after sieving and cleaning, the food grains are dried completely under sun for suitable period, and after which this can be fumigated by covering the food grains for about 48 hours by using the suitable fumigant like ethylene dichloride and carbon tetrachloride mixture under gas proof covers. So 48 hour fumigation can be done after sun drying. Fumigation of infested grains with methyl bromide is also effective and kills all stages of the paste, including eggs. So these are the different type of fumigants, that is ethylene dibromide, ethylene dichloride, carbon tetrachloride, methyl bromide, methyl chloride. So these are the fumigants. So fumes or the vapors of which will help in killing different stages of the stored grain paste. So fumigation is the best practice so as to avoid the poisoning of the stored food grains, and this will also help for the protection of the food grains from the food poisoning or toxicity of the pesticides. So this is about the rice weevil. So today we'll stop here, and next time we'll explain the remaining stored grain paste, that is pulse beetle. So till then,